Alrighty, welcome everyone. I'm Tiabu and I am here for Chiayafuru. We are picking up where we left off with episode 5 in the midst of a conflict, a battle, a match. Currently, we have Chiaya facing off against yet another genuine real threat contender to the queen title, one Haruka Inokuma, who is a former queen for, I think, 4 years running and was actually a major competitor and something of a rival to, shit, I forgot her name, the Fujisaki teacher who's really, really attractive. Just completely slipped my mind. I knew I had it. We'll probably get it eventually. Doesn't matter. Serious contender, has kids, is now coming back to the Karuta world because she's passionate about it, and we find out as she begins to battle Chihaya that she's got that same kind of hearing talent that Chihaya does, except hers is quite a bit more refined, and she has a better sense for more variations of the starting symbol than Chihaya is experienced enough to have at this point. So that's pretty cool. In other matches at the same time, Harada is facing off against Murao, and Taichi is facing off against Sudo, which is turning into an interesting battle in its own right. But of course, most of our focus at the moment is on this interesting match between Chihaya and Inokuma. Love to see how everything plays out from here. I'm interested. I will say that in hindsight, I probably should have just bit the bullet and watched one more episode last week, because it's pretty likely that we'll probably finish up some of this tournament match stuff in this next episode, and then we'll probably start on a new set of story path in the episode immediately after that, so it becomes kind of awkward with the two episodes per week. I probably could have just watched one, but hey, maybe I did a good, and this match will actually take two episodes, and we'll end up wrapping up at a nice place today. Who knows? We'll just play it by ear and see as usual. Anyway, we're in the middle of a match, and it's going all kinds of directions. I don't really know what's going to happen. We could go any number of directions with this. Chihaya could win, Chihaya could lose, Taichi could win, Taichi could lose, Arata could win, Arata's going to win, probably. it's pretty likely. But it's mostly up in the air at this point, and there are some interesting things with Chihaya's new, it's not really new knowledge, but better awareness of the space where her cards are, given her left-handed play for a little while, and we'll see how much of that comes into play here. Okay, I think that's a pretty good intro. Let's go ahead and dive on into Chiayafuru Season 3, Episode 5. I've got the episode up and ready to go. It's horrible subs as usual. There will be two versions of this reaction. As usual, you can find a picture-in-picture version with the video up there, linked in the description, and a timer-based version up on YouTube. If you want to do a syncy thing and sync up your own copy of these episodes with the timer-based version, you are welcome to do so. Just get your copy ready, because the beep-beep timer to count you down will be coming at you now. And it looks like we're starting with the OP again, so cool. I need more tea. I just realized that one frame of her and Taichi and Arata, that they have the maple leaves over it, but they're colored greens. So they just like look like pot. Oops. Mount Amanogaku. Kagu. Oh my god, I can't. Sweet. This is nice and tense. The card that you couldn't take from her. Nice. Now is a flash of them fighting. Did you see that? Looked like they messed up the pattern on her Oh. That's pretty cute. Yeah, I knew she was gonna notice. No, let him stay. Oh. Oh shit, it's real now. But I'm greedy. And I'm not throwing away my shot. Watch Hamilton, by the way. Just go and watch Hamilton. All right. Ruh-roh. She knew. Is it that, or did she just know? Fuck. Oh. That actually makes sense. Doubling up on the Pito vibes. She's back. A worthy opponent. They just both blew the enough wind to move it. They both know. All right, Jihai, you're a real cute girl. Cool as a cucumber. That makes sense. Nothing on that. Yeah, but she's Chihaya. Not quite, but she had a fever. Hi, Arata. How's your game going? You already won. No? What? He lost? Oh. Oops. I don't recognize this track. And Harada Falls. Yeah. Team game, baby. Oh. One card left. Four cards left. Donaru. All right. That is a cool shot. Dude, I am loving this episode so far. What was that? Eight. 30 impacto frame. She won it. Good night. She's getting there. Oh, Jesus. 1-1. So hype. What you gonna do? Was that it? Fucking nice. Okay. Tai Chi goes on. Morale goes on. Chihaya goes on. What's the last one? What was the last match? I'll take it myself. Ha 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 ha. Ha 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 ha. I like that. And that's the third one. Like, it gives us a bit of a. Oh! We don't ever see anything of Chitose. What are you. What's up, Chitose? Is it gonna be Meru Meru? Meru Meru? Thanks, Mom. She's Karate-ing. Bye, Mom. Yeah. What? We never see the family. 12 installments, Jesus. Oh, Mom. Hiroshi. Okay. That's a tough one. What? What? Might miss their ride home. And he's used to it. What? Well, I guess she gets a bye. Thanks, buddy. That would have been a tough match. Hi, Tai Chi. Show your stuff. Okay, this pushes Chi Hai out of the way for a little while so that we can Tai Chi it up. Oh, really? Ouch. Damn right. You got the real deal, kid. Yeah. Go prove yourself. Yeah. Yeah, he is real scary. Ho 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 ho. Glitching back to the past. Oh, that is pretty. Let's keep in touch. Damn. All right. Sorry, but like it's not formal. It doesn't matter. Haruka Queen. But not her. Wow. Damn. Damn, Harada Sensei. I love you, buddy. Oh, buddy. Oh. What is happening in Chihaya's brain? This is like a Chihaya, a Tai Chi mind palace.
Boy.
He'll be fine. It'll be fine. Oh.
Okay, Connor.
Yeah, so she doesn't know that it was yielded to her because she was asleep. Is Tai Chi sweeping? He's kind of sweeping. That's new. We got some moves. Just pure focus. Ha 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 ha. Looks like he's losing, bud. He got there. Oh. Yeah, how do you feel about that, Arata? Your mentor just got bopped. I didn't put that together in my head until that moment. Wait, does that mean Tai Chi versus... Oh. 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 I'm excited. All right. This episode felt super different. wonder if there's a different episode director. I'm just going to check ANN. Okay. Well, I'm trying to check ANN for, to see if there's a different episode director or something that I can, like, pinpoint for why this episode felt so different to me. But it's not loading. Thanks. Thanks, internet. I appreciate the not loading thing. That's real helpful. So we're just going to ignore it for now. I will say that this episode felt really different. A couple of pieces of soundtrack that I just don't recognize. They may have been used before, and I may be just mind-blanking because I'm not the best at recognizing pieces of music, and that's totally fair. But some pieces of soundtrack that I didn't quite recognize that were new and exciting and interesting. And then the way some of these scenes and sequences were put together felt different. I mean, the easiest one to note is this ending scene where we just have the music swelling over all of these shots of character faces after Tai Chi turns around, and we get all of these flashing, like, on a rhythm. Yeah. That feels a little different. Feels kind of unique for Chi Ayafuru. I'm not sure what to think of it. It's cool, though. It's cool, though. This episode flowed together really well, and just in general, the way we paced through this match was wonderful. And to fit in all of the little side character moments that we did get throughout the course of this episode, the Chitose moment, the moment with her mom where we realize how much her mom is, like, really kind of rooting for her daughters to do well in their respective fields and stuff. The different conversations about the meaning of things and the meaning of characters that are aging up out of Karuta, and Haruka's difference from them, how she wants to go back in and is tired of losing without even trying. That's just great. That's really cool. Okay, I wrote down one timestamp in this episode. I wrote down 8:30 Impacto frame, because there was in this final card... There. In this final card between the two of them, we're just going to frame by frame because we'll miss it if we don't. Starts speaking, and then we get this. The sketchy impact frame that turns into just blur. And then that. But all of it together with sound. That's awesome. And this is one of the songs that I don't recognize, I believe. It's got chimes in it, it's got bells. Wow, that's a great track. It is perfect, and it's perfectly used. I really like this episode. A lot. And leading into a battle that we haven't seen for a long time, a real match between Tai Chi and Chihaya, which we've kind of lampshaded for, not lampshaded, that's the wrong thing. We've kind of foreshadowed a little bit. Didn't we have a moment, an episode or two ago where somebody said, like, oh yeah, but you've never really faced Tai Chi in a real match. You don't really know how he really is when he's playing for realsies, for keeps. Oh man. So both Tai Chi and Chihaya went to this training camp. Got good, got better, are improving, and now they're going to end up facing each other, which they haven't had a chance to do for a while. This is anyone's game. Chihaya's rested, but Tai Chi's got his game face on. Oh, that's hype. Oh, that's hype. All right, I really like this episode. I like the way it's structured. I like the side bits that we get with Chitose and the mother. I like the character moments that we get between these two and the character moment that we get for Harada Sensei. And just the setup here at the end is fantastic. But this whole episode is packed with really fun things, and was an absolute joy to watch. I really liked this one. Okay, well, I'm a little bit too excited for what's about to come to spend too much time lingering on episode 5 here. So let's take a quick breaky thingy, do a sinky thingy, and I will be back in just a moment for episode 6. So see you there. Peace. All right, welcome back. We are good to go for episode 6, and in the meantime, while I was doing a sinky thing, my ANN page loaded, and I found out who episode directed and storyboarded this episode of Chiaiafuru. The episode director is... Oh shit, I just lost it. It's Kunio Katsuki, who directed episodes 5, 12, and 19, but going through his list, though he is prolific as a key animator and animation director and sometimes episode director, there's nothing that really gives me a clear indication of, like, a particular individual style. Where I do get an indication of a particular individual style is the storyboard, which was done on this episode and episode 10 by Atsuko Ishizuka, Jesus, who is a relatively familiar name because I just started Soriyori or Yorimoi, and she's the director of it. So I'm going to just chalk up some of the stuff to the storyboards being done by Ishizuka-san. So I'll leave it there. Anyway, we got a match to watch now. I kind of hope that it just takes the one episode, but at the same time, I kind of hope that it takes more than one episode because I want this match to have a lot to it. We'll just play it by ear. If it does take more than an episode, there's a good chance that we're going to just watch another one because I want to see how this plays out. But we'll have to wait till the end of this episode 6 to actually figure that out. In any case, Taichi. The man with the mind castle versus Chihaya, the girl with the schmooves. Who's gonna come out on top? I have no idea. This could go either way. Taichi doesn't beat Chihaya very often. It doesn't happen super frequently, but they could both be really thrown by this particular situation. And that's exciting. So let's watch episode 6 and see how this plays. I've got it up. It's ready. Beep, beep timer. Indeed. Indeed. Yeah. Not like this. Not like this. Who cares? Who? I could not care less. I could not care less. Come on. Show me what I want to see. I mean, I'm down for some Hyoro antics, but like, come on. Not right now. Let's keep the laser focus on the important stuff, please. Yes, it looks like pot. He is tired, and she is rested. Okay. Mm-hmm. Fair, fair. Ja.
Heirate.
Oh, you gotta leave? Fuck. All right.
There was so much emotion in that. Oh, buddy. Buddy.
Yeah. Oh, hi, buddy. Yeah, a couple hundred practice matches. Yeah. Hey, thanks, bud. Oh, I hate driving at night. Fair.
Okay.
Who detects texting? Today I learned. A ritual built into an article of clothing. I did not know that. Oh, shit. Fucking hell. Worth it. Worth it. Yeah. Yeah. Valuable information gathering. And I didn't want to. Oh. Sumire. Sure, but not like this. Oh. Yeah, he's pretty dope. Sure. He's catching up. Arrangement that knows her cards. What are you doing, buddy? He's got a plan here, though. Yeah, he knows all your weaknesses. But what's it gonna be? What is he doing? Wow. But yeah, but not Chihaya fast. This is a battle. I'm so excited. Ah, Mind Palace, baby. He just taught himself, man. Sure has. She's doing the Tai Chi thing. She could sense the differences. Yeah. Emperor's just like, does anybody else see this shit? Plus one chipping point. Huh? Oh. Between friends. Yeah! Wholesome battle! Everything's been together. Yeah! Wholesome battle! Yeah, but it's like queen match level. Ooh, that bass. Ooh. Completely. No. But you're, if anybody could do it. Wow, we got that as a wide. That's great. And you are already tired. For now. Maximum strong. Oh, that's not your mindset, girl. Don't know what that means. I don't know what that means. Semi-double fault? I don't know what that means. I don't care. Chihaya, get your mindset together. I can't lose anything. That's not your mindset, Chihaya. Yeah. Tai Chi. I get it though. I get it though. She was getting stuck in her own head. But no, I'm just playing Tai Chi. Send a card, take it back. Oh. Oh. What happened there? Yep.
Doesn't matter. Cards are cards.
Back in her mindset. Nice.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. Yeah. I'm sure you do. We'll see.
Oh.
And she's actually seeing him.
Sumi Ray.
Yes, Kana. Thank you for the perspective. She was texting. Yeah, all right. What? I made it to the final. Don't you fucking end right now. No! Passion, baby. Love for the game. Motherfuck, cut to ED. Ooh. I really like the CD song though.
Motherfucker, goddammit, good shit, fuck.
I really like the ED song. I'm glad we got that little scene with the mom. I hope she does the like rush over there thing. That could be really good. Well, we're going to watch another one. There's no choice. It felt like we could have wrapped this in this episode, but no. The hype is too real. All right, this was a pretty exciting episode. I'm so glad that we didn't intersperse this whole thing with segments of Hyoro versus this guy, because I could not care less. Like, we have the setup for the hypest match in a long, long time. And yeah, I'm just glad. I'm just very glad. Anyway, Arata gets to stay. It's very sweet. It's quite wonderful. She gives him some tips about the stuff and then tells him some stuff about the way that the Obi is designed, which I didn't know, and I actually don't know if it's true, but that's pretty cool if it is. An entire ritual built into a piece of a garment is fascinating. Taichi whips out the brand new layout that he has prepped apparently specifically for Chihaya, and we go into an extended sequence of everybody's hair blowing in non-existent wind and everybody looking super badass, and it is and it's just the dopest thing. It's so cool. And then we get into the match, and we sort of montage our way through it a little bit. It's just like back and forth. And then interspersed with little moments of this is what we've been working for, and Taichi sitting back and like realizing that he can do this, and then interspersed with little moments of them being still friendos and not being worried about this and kind of pushing each other to their best selves. And it's pretty fucking awesome. It was really good. Lots of great faces in the episode. Lots of great moments in the episode. Excellent use of music, as usual, as we've come to expect. And hints at what is to come. Lots of little character moments in everything. Everyone sitting around watching this match is having a touchstone moment of revelation or realization about themselves and their relationship with Karata as well. With Kana doing this, Tsutomu talking to her, Arata watching them and wondering what the hell he's doing, and then, of course, Taichi and Chihaya actually doing the play in themselves. Oh, it's pretty good. But it ain't over yet. We gotta watch one more, because I'm not waiting a week. There's no way. Yeah, there's just no way. So, let's take a breaky thingy, do a sinky thingy, and come back for episode 7. See you in a minute. Peace. All right, welcome back. We are on to what should be the final episode of the day, episode 7 of Chihayafuru season 3. Let's hopefully wrap up this match and see how it goes. It could go either way. I'm pretty excited. So let's dive in. Beep beep timer. Gotta get my own shoulders loose, jeez. The storm blasts. All right. Straight into it. Results, baby. The proof in the pudding. Now you do. Sure. Making a name. Nope, but one day. One day. Glory. Okay, or that.
Who touched it?
These split panels are awesome. Yeah, one of them is gonna win. All the support from all the side characters, all on this moment. Oh, it's so dope. Wait, was that the last card? Motherfuck, you're just gonna end it immediately. Bruh. I'm actually mad. I thought it was gonna be the whole episode. I'm actually mad. They really could have finished the match in the last episode. Motherfuckers. I'm so mad. Good night. Yeah. Rip. Hey, I thought you played real good. Also, you're hot. Yeah, not today, bud. Not today. One day. One day. Wait. Okay, I thought for a second that mom came. True. Yeah, they don't know about the Muda part yet. You mean Inokuma as well? Holy shit. Me too, bud. Right, fuck. Jesus, there's stuff going on in the world too. God damn it. Blink. Yeah. All right, Empress. All right, thank you. Mom? It's Mom! Oh, she came. A little bit, but that's okay. Ooh. Yeah. I won! Oh, never mind. Oh. Oh. Oh! That... That went a direction I didn't expect. That's wasting water, bud.
Nah, just sitting here, staring at the water. Yeah, everything's fine. Totally. Sure, bud. Nope. Also, uh-oh. Okay. Okay. So, not going to the qualifier match. A lot of exams, yeah. Alright, alright. Who the fuck are you? That tracks. What? That was a great gag. He's going to the qualifier. Yeah, he went. Girl, you got ditched. Oh, fuck. And now you're not even enjoying your own class trip. God damn it. She's all in her own head. Yep. Awkward. I mean, there's one reason. Oh, never mind. Okay, never mind. I was actually kind of excited for Taichi going to a... That's some death. Who's he calling? Hey. Oh, you sneaky boy. You fuck. That's my boy. Thank God you're not doing that dumb Karuta stuff. I hate her. Oh, hello. Mm-hmm. Yikes. Yeah, it's a scary. Yeah. You're up. Yep. You're my punching bag. Come here. Those are some bruised feet. Sure. Yeah. Hi. Sweet. Oh, Wincana. You can try. Can't let him get ahead. Why? Could you even register at this point? I guess you don't know him as well as you thought you did. This is last shot. Yeah. What's going on with Arata? The conversation with Taichi? That was a cool transition. That was a cool bike wheel. CG, but cool. He doesn't think Taichi's gonna be there. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh, hi! Family restaurant. Yep. Oh, thanks, you. Maybe. That's a pretty great reward. Shut up. Yeah. You did. Realization. Thanks, you. Plus 1 point. Yeah, what did her parents make? No, she's in love with you. Those are your pajamas? What the fuck? He's here. He's here. And Chihaya is not competing. Man, this episode was a roller coaster emotionally. It started with fuck you. You gotta spend a minute resolving the cliffhanger that suckered me into watching another episode, and then turned into a roller coaster of stuff. I'm set up for another tournament. Qualifier. That's a lot. Okay. Well, as I said, we got kind of suckered into another episode, which then very rapidly resolved its thing with, like, literally one card. I was kind of hoping for a little bit more there. I kind of thought that there could have been a little bit more there, but no. No, we just chose to do it this way because cliffhangers are valuable for seasonal anime. God damn it. But that's okay, because once that was resolved, we went into some pretty awesome character moments for everybody. Chihaya deciding that she wants to go on the school trip, not just because it's an important thing for high schoolers, which I think is ridiculous anyway, but because she's following up on what she said before and what she wrote down on her career form. She wants to become a high school teacher, and what kind of high school teacher would she be if she hadn't even gone on her own class trip because she was playing Karata? She'll get other chances to do the Karata thing, but she won't get other chances to go on her high school class trip. Okay. Okay. It's a moment for Chihaya. Now, narratively, what this does is it means that we've got Taichi and Arata on effectively two sides of a bracket for the Master Qualifier tournaments. That's exciting. That's very exciting. Yeah, that's very exciting. And Shinobu in the Queen Qualifiers. There's a lot that can happen with that. And we've got this nice little setup with the conversation that Taichi and Arata have on the stairs about the ownership of Chihaya. And then we get a moment with Arata, going home, seeing you, getting the katsudon and the katsukuri, and coming to the realization that he doesn't need a reward for achieving his dream. And I feel like that we were attempting to indicate that, like, Chihaya is the reward that he's thinking of, and he's like, wait a sec, that's stupid. I shouldn't be thinking that way. She's not really somebody who's owned by anybody. Yeah, that makes sense. That works for me. I don't know if that's the intent, but that works for me. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Lots of drama in this episode, though. Some nice goofy moments. Man, they really pulled me all over the place with this whole Taichi thing. I was sure at first, 100% sure that he was just pretending to have a fever so that he could skip and go to the Karate tournament. And then we see him in his room, and I'm like, oh, well, never mind. I guess he actually has a fever. But then, no, he goes to the Karate tournament, and he was kind of... We don't know if he was pretending, but I feel like he was pretending. And eventually, yeah, he figures it out. And she freaks out. I hate his mom. Can I just say that again? I hate his mother a lot. She really ticks me off all the time. In any case, everybody's getting prepped. This is a big-time preparation episode as opposed to a big-time finale for a big tournament episode. Some Kana trying a wingman, some everybody getting ready for the tournament, and everybody getting up in their own heads about what they're going to do during this tournament. We will see. We will see. I think for me, the primo moment, besides seeing Shinobu in this ridiculous getup, which is ridiculous, That is the most insane clown clothing that I have ever seen. What the fuck even? Polka dot or like weird bubble dots with strange plaid and... Come on, this isn't a Shaft show. Be reasonable, please. And he's got that particular Snomaru Dorayaki that we saw the advertisements for when Chihaya was looking out over the city. Shows that he knows who she is, but he seems to be here more to taunt her than anything else. This fucking guy. Also, oh, that's a voice. Who is Master Suo? Like, I need to know. Suo? How do I spell his name? Let me find the Japanese cast. Oe Hana no Tsukuba Komaro. Oe you. Suo. Oh, it's Suo. Hiroki Tochi. I don't recognize that name immediately. Oh, Jesus, everything. He's everybody and everything. Bard and Black Butler. Wait, what? Tepe Sugo. Okay, he's in too many things to go through at the moment. Fuck it, whatever.
Great voice. Honestly, a little bit of chills in this particular moment. And some of that just excitement that we finally get to see Suo entering into one of the tournaments that our characters are going to, and we get to see what this guy is actually all about. I assume that he's going to be the most OP, most bullshit player in the universe, given that we talked about him before and he had like 38 single syllable cards. Fuck you. Fuck you. That's some bullshit. So, cool episode. It's probably a good thing that we watched this one, because then I'm not going into the next week with the expectation that we're going to spend any time on the Chihaya versus Taichi match. And we know what's coming up. It's going to be the qualifying tournaments. And everybody's there except for Chihaya, basically. That's pretty cool. It's pretty exciting. Okay, well, we can wrap there for the day. I've been Tiabu. This has been Chiayafuru Season 3, Episodes 6, 7, and 8? No, 5, 6, and 7. Yes, thank you. Episodes 5, 6, and 7. I hope you've enjoyed them as much as I have, and I hope to catch you next week when we actually kick off this tournament in full swing. See you there. Peace.